This video will complete the appendicular skeleton with the lower limb, notably from proximal to distal, the thigh, leg, and foot. And we'll start with the bones of the thigh, which include the femur and patella. The femur is your thigh bone, of course, the largest and strongest bone in the body. It's a quarter of your height, and it articulates at the proximal end, which is the hip end, with the acetabulum, the socket of the pelvic girdle. At the distal end of the femur, it'll articulate with the tibia, which is your shin bone, and anteriorly with the patella, patella being your kneecap. So if we take a look at a picture of the femur and the patella, there are a lot of projections on the femur because we needed a lot of attachment points for the large muscles in the legs through their tendons to pull on the femur to move you around. You got the head of the femur, which is your ball of your ball and socket joint of the hip. There's the neck. We have different projections like the greater trochanter, lesser trochanter, linea aspera, all attachment points. And then we have these two large rounded joint surfaces, the lateral and medial condyle, where the femur will articulate with the tibia. Distal to the knee, we have the lower leg, sometimes just called the leg, which consists of two bones. The tibia is the medial leg bone, which contains the medial malleolus, while the fibula is the lateral lower leg bone, which contains the lateral malleolus. The tibia is much thicker than the fibula because it takes all of your weight, where the fibula does not take any of your weight. It is simply attached to the lateral end of the lower leg. Here we can see the more massive tibia with a lot of good landmarks, like the lateral and medial condyles, and the tibial tuberosity, where your patellar tendon inserts into. At the distal end near your ankle, we have a medial malleolus. Here is your fibula, the lateral bone of the lower leg, which is not weight-bearing, with the fibular head at the proximal end and the lateral malleolus at the distal end. On each leg, there are 7 tarsal bones, which is your ankle and the posterior half of the foot. These are your 7 tarsal bones, the cuboid, navicular, and then there's 3 cuneiforms, which we'll see on an image in a little bit. Moving distal from the ankle and back of the foot, we have 5 metatarsals, numbered 1 to 5, sometimes with Roman numerals, number 1 being on the big toe side. We'll see that in a second. And as distal as we can get in the lower extremities, we have phalanges, 14 bones of the toes. So, here is our image. These are your 7 tarsals with your talus. Your tibia will sit on the talus and articulate with it. Your heel bone is the calcaneus. On the lateral side, we have a cuboid bone. On the medial side, we have navicular. And the cuneiforms fill in the last space with the medial, intermediate, and lateral cuneiforms to end your 7 tarsals. Move distally, and we have 5 metatarsals, numbered 1 through 5 from the big toe to the little toe. Distal to the metatarsals, we have 14 phalanges, just like we did in the hand, with a proximal, middle, and distal phalanx on each digit, except for the big toe that only has 2 phalanges, a proximal and a distal.